Officer, please. Do you know how many times I've complained? I've been on that ruddy phone all night.
We're sort of weary now, aren't we?
You were here before, but you didn't do anything, and it's just got worse. They've been effing and blinding up and down the street, and terrible fighting.
So, Kayla, why don't you just leave it to us to sort it for you, all right?
I'll be making an official complaint anyway.
Yes, madam.
Everybody is in the place, let's go! Everybody is in the place, let's go! Everybody is in the place,
let's go! Come here! Don't get the others!
Everybody is in the place, let's go!
Okay, who's in charge here?
Invites only, man.
You looking to get yourself nicked or something? Right. You just got your wish.
Sarge!
Go on, Dave! You're nicked.
Thanks, Sarge.
Amanda.
What are you doing here?
Watch your back.
Trent. Tony, get rid of that lot, will you?
Dodge.
Come on, budge up. Yeah, as long as this one's not sick all over me.
Right. Give me some welly, Tony. I'm dying for a bacon sarnie.
Right, tank number three then.
Come on, mate.
Not a bad catch, eh, Bob?
Yeah.
Where'd you get? Look, I'll do what I can for you, Amanda, but I'm already out on a limb by bringing you back in the car, yeah? Come on.
So that's what kept George at the party.
Look at the state of her.
What happened to you? Still a runner.
I'd have come to your assistance, George, if you'd only asked.
Yeah. Bit behind, aren't you, George?
Yes, Sarge. We had to make a stop on the way back. Amanda wanted to be sick.
Well, she didn't make a miss of the panda.
No, Sarge.
So what's the charge this time?
I found her with these, Sarge.
You get worse, don't you? What are you, 15 now? Where's your father?
At work.
Have you got a number? Come on, Amanda. There's no way he's not going to know about it, so the sooner the better.
It's in the books at security.
I'll call him, Sarge.
How did you get in this state?
I fell over.
Some fall. You're hallucinating?
Never mind. Tell it to the surgeon.
What's it got to do with anyone else?
Look, in here, you're my responsibility. You're going to have treatment. What's your probation officer going to say to you this time, eh?
Hello, can I speak to Simon Jones, please?
Look, it wasn't drugs that did this. It was him.
Yeah, OK. Yeah, I'll hold.
We're talking indecent assault.
Indecent assault?
Dad is going to have a word with her, see what the story is.
Right.
And I've sent Garfield off to the canteen.
I'll see him later.
Yeah.
You've dropped yourself right in it this time, George.
If you'd have been bothered to check the house before you went swanning off, I wouldn't have been left to bring her in on my own, would I?
While you were prattin' about in that house, I was busting a gut nicking a drug dealer. I thought you'd gone.
Yeah, well, I hadn't, had I?
I don't want any coffee. Why don't you just leave me alone?
Okay, okay.
I don't want to talk.
Whatever you want, Amanda.
I've had to advise the Chief Super and MS-15, and they will be here shortly, breathing down our necks. Since when did we start transporting female prisoners single-handed, Garfield?
Oh, I know the girl, sir.
Oh, you do, do you?
Well, I thought I did. Obviously, I don't. I never thought she'd pull a stunt like this, sir.
Well, she has. And now you've got a CIB investigation hanging over you. And where was the coordination? Is this the way we run a simple operation at Sun Hill?
It was my fault, sir. I was distracted by the activity outside. We did make 6 arrests, including this drug dealer, and I left Garfield to secure the premises. But I was not aware that he'd also made an arrest. I'm afraid I was a bit remiss, sir. And I'm sorry.
All I can say is she must have a vivid imagination if she thinks George has given her one.
I don't think he knows where it is yet, does he?
Yeah, well, I reckon he's a right pillar for not calling assistance. And I tell you what, when MS-15 gets hold of him...
Now, send someone like Reed down to slap his wrist and it'll all be over by lunch. As it happens, I agree with Steve.
Here we go.
Now, look, listen. On an allegation of this magnitude, as far as MS-15 are concerned, they have to be seen to be siding with the complainants.
What does it matter? George didn't do it. And he's got, what, 7 years unblemished service?
I'm telling you, with MS-15, it's them and us.
Yeah, I'll go along with that.
They're a breed apart. Like pit bulls.
Inspector Monroe seems very strict.
Well, believe me, Paul, Sunhill's a damn good nick. That's not to say we might not run up against the odd difficult character.
Morning, Mum.
Frank.
This is a pleasant surprise.
My colleague, D.S. Paul McCourt, D.I. Burnside.
I've heard mention of you, sir.
Yeah, well, I believe everything you hear.
I tend not to, sir.
You know about this allegation against George Garfield, I suppose?
I think I heard it on Jack and Ori.
It certainly doesn't sound like the George Garfield I know.
Well, even if it is a non-starter, I suppose you've still got to spin through the motions, haven't you?
Paul, do you want to go along to the conference room? Frank, I'm here to investigate a serious allegation. I intend to conduct a thorough and rigorous inquiry, and I don't care who's in the frame.
I wouldn't expect anything else, Ma.
Good. Because if you know anything, a bit of cooperation would be appreciated.
Well, nothing springs to mind. But you do know that our Miss Jones has got form for theft.
Yes, I checked her PNC record to see if she'd made any previous allegations.
What about the surgeon's report?
Well, she hasn't been examined yet. She's waiting at the rape suite for her father to turn up.
Which no doubt he will, baying for police blood.
Complaints all the rage, Frank. It's a cross we have to bear.
Not exactly what you joined the job for, though, was it, Mum? Policing the police?
It's part of the job, Frank, and as long as I'm asked to do it, I will.
Rather you than me.
Can I see Amanda now?
Of course, Mr. Jones. She's just having a shower.
How is she?
Well, she's still very upset.
Has she been... I want to know.
We don't know yet exactly what happened, but perhaps now that you're here, Amanda will find it easier to talk.
I have to ask you to surrender all the clothes you're wearing for forensic examination.
Is this really necessary?
I'll come with you to the locker room.
This is what was found on her. This looks like coke, and these are probably ecstasy.
Thanks, Bob. Was she acting strangely at all, as if she might have been stoned?
Yeah, she seemed all right, a bit tearful. But as soon as she made the allegation, she broke down.
Hardly surprising if she'd just been attacked.
If she had been.
Right, thanks. We better get over to the rape suite. There was just one more thing. I haven't spoken to Sergeant Boyden yet, but perhaps you'll know. Why was PC Garfield bringing Amanda back in the car unescorted?
Well, you'll have to ask Sergeant Boyden that, ma'am.
Of course, thanks.
I do know that PC Garfield knew the girl. Perhaps he was just...
Just what?
Well, just trying to help out the relief. Save calling them back again.
You're right. I'll wait and see what Sergeant Boyden says.
Mr. Parker, can you hear me?
Do you want a solicitor?
Forget it, Dave. We'll interview him later.
Yeah, but don't you think we...
We all know what can happen if you get overeager.
Just give her time, Mr. Jones.
Morning, Narika.
Morning, Mom. This is Mr. Jones, Amanda's father, Superintendent Reed.
My colleague, Detective Sergeant McCourt.
Look what he's done to her. I want to see the animal behind bars.
Mr. Jones, I suggest for the sake of your daughter, we try and keep this conversation civil.
She trusted him.
Dad, don't.
I think we better step outside for chat, Mr. Jones. Mr.
Mr. Jones, whilst I have every sympathy with you, I must say that your attitude is not helping your daughter.
Oh, yeah, the police have helped her a lot, haven't they? I've never seen her in such a state, and it's not because of me, is it?
I didn't mean it like that.
You'll try and put her off, won't you? Say she imagined it or something.
We're from a special department of Scotland Yard called MS-15. We're not connected with the officer nor with Sunhill Police Station. Our investigation is impartial.
Don't give me that. He's a copper. He's one of your own.
I can assure you, Mr. Jones, as a police officer and as a woman, the last thing I'd do is protect a sex attacker.
My dad's not usually rude.
Did you get on well with him?
I'm all he's got.
What about your mum? Did you ever see her?
No. She went off. It doesn't matter.
We just need to ask you some questions, Amanda. Enrique, would you mind? Do you want your dad to sit next to you? Amanda, I need you to tell me whatever you can about the attack. The more you can tell me, the better. Not just for me, but for yourself. It'll help you to talk about it. I want you to go through it step by step, and even if you don't think something's important, I want you to tell me anyway, okay?
He attacked me. What else can I say?
How did he attack you, Amanda?
I was trying to get away. He was ripping my clothes, my hair. Trying to rip them off. I fell into the gravel. He knew.
He knew what, Amanda?
I'm on probation. He knew they'd lock me up.
If you were charged for drugs?
Yes.
Did he want to have sex with you?
Yes.
In return for not taking you in?
Yes. But I wouldn't let him.
Here.
What you got?
A bit of clothing. Could be part of a dress.
And they say romance is dead.
As you're obviously aware, we're investigating this allegation against George Garfield, and there are one or two things you may be able to help us with.
Far away, Mum.
Did you know that PC Garfield and Amanda Jones were friends?
It's news to me.
He didn't mention it when he went to raid the party?
No.
It's a bit strange, isn't it?
Maybe he was embarrassed.
Were you aware that PC Garfield was going to bring Amanda back in a panda car?
No, Mum.
So, you didn't really know what PC Garfield was up to during this raid, despite the fact that you were in charge of it.
I didn't tell him anything, George. There's nothing for you to tell, is there? I think they've sussed you've been given at one. Is that what they think? I was just trying to be nice. Well, just because I usually wear a uniform, it doesn't mean I can't be nice sometimes. No, of course not. But I understand. Understand what? How it is. I just came in to see if Garfield wanted a solicitor, Mum.
You're aware you're not supposed to be in here, Sergeant.
Yes, Mum.
And does PC Garfield want a solicitor?
Well, I was just...
I don't need one. Thank you, Mum.
Well, that clears that up. We'll say no more about it, Sergeant.
Thank you, Mum.
PC Garfield, this interview will be tape recorded. I must caution you that anything you say may be used in evidence. Do you understand the caution?
Yes, Mum.
You're not under arrest, but you are entitled to free legal advice. Do you understand?
Yes, I understand, Mum, but I don't want any help.
I am Superintendent Reed from MS-15. Other officer present, Detective Sergeant McCourt, also from MS-15. Interview commences at 11:16. PC Garfield, you are under caution following an allegation of indecent assault made against you by Amanda Jones of No. 3 Elcott Road, Sun Hill.
Yes, Mum.
PC Garfield, can you tell me how well you know Amanda Jones?
Well, in the past, I've arrested her twice for shoplifting. She also has other convictions for theft. The first time I arrested her, she was 13. She had no mother, and she was trying to look after her father. I thought I might be able to help keep her out of trouble.
I see. So you've got to know her quite well, then?
No, not well, Mum. I just felt sorry for her.
Do you always feel sorry for people you arrest?
No, Mum, of course not. But she's a bright girl. I didn't want to see her get on a downward spiral.
Do you know her well enough to visit her at home?
Well, I've popped in occasionally, if it's been on my beat.
Did you visit her when her father was out?
Well, most times he'll be in, but I had no way of knowing whether he'd be there or not.
On your visits to see Amanda, what did you do?
Oh, just chat. Asked her about school, talked to her about her boyfriends and that.
Why did you want to know about her boyfriends?
It was just something she used to bring up.
And on this shout to her house this morning, did you tell Sergeant Boyden that you knew Amanda lived there?
No, Mum.
Why not?
Well, I was going to tell him as we were going into the house, but with the noise and everything.
When you left the house with her, did you drive her straight back here?
No, Mum.
Why not?
I stopped Mum because she said she wanted to be sick.
So when Socco look, they'll find Amanda's vomit.
Well, she wasn't actually sick. She just said she was going to be.
It was your idea to stop the car, was it?
Yes. I didn't want to risk her messing it up.
Couldn't you tell whether she was genuinely sick or not?
No. I believed her. She acted as if she was going to be sick.
She says you stopped the car and suggested having sex with her.
Definitely not.
In exchange for letting her go.
No.
You knew she was on probation.
Yes.
And you knew that she would probably go into youth custody if she appeared in court on a drugs charge. Did you or didn't you?
Yes.
Is that why you tried to make a deal with her?
I didn't.
She says when she turned you down, you sexually assaulted her.
That's not true.
Then explain to me why she has cuts on her hands and legs and how her dress got torn.
She was trying to escape.
The surgeon says she's had recent sexual contact.
Not with me.
You've never had sex with her?
No.
It still doesn't add up to anything. Garfield says he stopped there. She says she was pushed. He says she fell. Same old story.
We haven't been to the scene yet.
I have. It's not the sort of place Garfield would take a bird. Even the rats don't fancy having it off there.
One suspect, one victim, and no witnesses.
I say we interview Garfield again, ma'am. Tell him Socco have got something.
And what have Socco got? Straws in the wind.
Thanks for your help, Frank.
I'll leave you to it then, ma'am.
OK, let's look at the points they've agreed on and what forensic might be able to tell. They certainly agree they already knew one another.
A fact which Garfield admitted to relate to Sergeant Boyden. He concealed the panda car in the next street.
Or parked it round the corner.
And they spent time together in the bedroom. In fact, just long enough for the others to be gone by the time they came out. He then drove her to the waste ground.
If he wanted sex, why didn't he stay where he was? Boyden had obliged him by emptying the house.
The waste ground gave him the chance to claim she was trying to escape.
Anyway, Socco concur. It's likely she came by her injuries there. What else?
She's definitely had recent sexual contact, but hasn't got a boyfriend.
Not necessarily fact. She is on probation, and her honesty is questionable. She was arrested for possession of drugs.
She hasn't denied it, ma'am. In fact, she's even admitted it. If she was trying to wriggle out of that, why didn't she just say Garfield had planted the drugs on her?
Because no one would believe her. No, if she wanted to get off the hook, she'd have to be a bit more ingenious than that.
So, what good would making this allegation do her?
If you were a magistrate about to sentence a young girl for possessing drugs, what would you think if the whole case were overshadowed by a sexual assault? I think she knew it would invoke a hell of a lot of sympathy.
It's a bit of a long shot, though, isn't it, ma'am?
What would she get for possession?
Could be youth custody, I suppose.
I think she's making a desperate bid for freedom. She's got nothing to lose and she knows it. Garfield, on the other hand, stands to lose the lot. He's got an untarnished record.
With respect, ma'am, I have to say it. You seem to be making PC Garfield out to be some kind of a saint.
I don't believe from what I know of him that he is a sex attacker.
He's fancied her for ages and tonight he was in with a chance. We know she's had sexual contact.
Why would he bring her back here afterwards?
Stephen, last night you were at a party at number 3 Elcott Road. Do you remember that?
We were all there. That's where we picked you up.
Yeah, I was there.
Do you remember what you had in your possession when you were arrested?
No.
Well, when we caught you, you tried to dispose of some pills and some powder.
Those substances are now awaiting laboratory analysis.
And I think the lab will confirm them to be 21 pills of ecstasy and 20 grams of cocaine, over £1,000 worth of drugs. You also had £200 of cash on you.
Yeah, I remember having some money on me. I don't know nothing about drugs.
Did you go to that party with the intention of selling drugs?
No.
Were you aware that many of the youngsters at the party were taking drugs?
No.
Do you know what a Class A drug is, Stephen? Well, let me tell you that I believe what you had on you last night are Class A drugs. Do you know what possession with intent to supply means?
I've already checked your police record, Stephen.
Supplying drugs is one thing. Supplying them to kids is something else.
Look, I swear it, none of the drugs at that party came from me. On my life. I don't deal to kids. I've never done it. I don't need to do it. Look at my record.
So what are you doing there then, eh? Why weren't you at a proper rave? What were you doing hanging around at a kid's party? Eh?
I was visiting my girlfriend. All right? She lives there.
Ah, oh, Mr. Jones, we'd like to have another chat with Amanda.
Oh, come on. She's had enough for today. Let's just get her bowed and go home, eh?
I'm sorry, Mr. Jones, but some new evidence has come to light. We've been talking to Stephen Parker. He says he's your boyfriend, Amanda. Is that true?
No.
I put a stop to it. He's a drug pusher.
Amanda, did you see Stephen last night?
No.
He says you did. Why would he say that if you didn't?
He's probably stoned. I don't know.
He was picked up this morning running away from your house.
Maybe he popped in. I don't know.
He says you went upstairs to your bedroom together. Is that true? Stephen's already told us. Have you had sex with him?
No.
Stephen says you did.
He's lying.
He's already made a statement. I must ask you to think very carefully. Have you, in the last 24 hours, had sex with Stephen Parker? And the allegation that PC Garfield sexually assaulted you, is that true? I'll need to hear it from you, Amanda.
No.
Maybe youth custody will sort her out.
I doubt it.
You've never had much faith in the system, have you, Frank?
I don't know. Maybe today proves something works.
Oh, you don't see MS-15 as the enemy within, then?
You're a necessary evil.
Thanks a lot.
Listen, I'd rather have you than some raving loony council committee. We'd still be here this time next week listening to the latest chapter of Amanda Jones's tale of woe. And I imagine that Garfield would be strung up by his tackle from the nearest lamppost.
All right, George?
Yeah, fine, Sarge. No thanks to you.
Look, I'm sorry.
Yeah. Not half as sorry as I am.